and being able to pull out your phone and plug in this number, and you may never need it, but if you do need it, at least you have somebody to ask, okay? So get your phone out and type in this number. Do you have yours with you?
No, I don't.
Okay, so make sure that you write down the number somewhere that you're gonna have. And this is my number, like my phone for just like texting. And the cool thing about texting is I don't have your number. So this is the anonymous Ask a Librarian, okay, that we have. Another thing that you can do is my name, Carrie Cornelius. And you can message me if you don't like paying phone bills and you're just on Messenger. And I think on Snapchat. You want to make certain that you follow us. I actually use my Indian name for that one. But students are finding it with Ask a Library, and that's where this name is.
Is that the library's name?
Yes. I don't have it for myself. I don't do any personal stuff on there. It's just kind of the library. So number one is making certain that you have a connection. Like, I think Trio sponsors some tutoring, that you have 24-hour tutoring. I usually wake up about 3:00 in the morning. I might be down before 11, but I just turn off my sound when I'm sleeping. So I don't want you to feel like you're imposing, okay? And at this stage in my life, I'm cool with that. So you just ask your questions. Some of the questions I get are, I don't know how to narrow my topic. Or else I'm getting, I can't find, my topic is too narrow and I'm not finding enough sources for it. So those are some of the questions, let alone what time does the library open? I get that all the time. But we do have our website so that you can, and I would probably say that we're most common posting on Facebook with anytime you ask the library. So today's topic is MLA. What is MLA? Do you guys know what it is?
It's the format you need to use.
Yeah. You can peek through that book. MLA. So it's a format. What else do you know about it? Micah, did you have to use it in high school?
Kind of.
Kind of?
Yeah.
How about you?
Yeah.
You use it, so you're pretty cool with it?
Yeah.
Is your right hand and left hand? That's good. How about you? Have you used it before? Oh, man! We should just skip to our quizzes on there. Have you used it before? Have you used it?
Oh, yeah, I used it before.
What the heck? All right. So let's start with the quiz on there. And you can use your phones on here. And we'll just kind of play. So get your phone out, and what you're going to do is go into Safari on there, or else your Google, or else you can just search and do it online. We're just going to go back and let's see, put in the search, and then we can go to the computer. And then once you're on, I think we're actually going to Kahoot. you going on your phone then?
We can go in.
Yeah. On the front page, and it's on this one. On the back page. You're going off your phone today? All right, so we have a game pin up there, and the game pin is 2, 8, 6, 5, 7, 3. And then from here, you're gonna make up a name for yourself. How about your team?
I hope you have some.
What's your team? Your eyes, you got a dark skin. Two more. Michelle, have you used?
No, I haven't.
So this one, I didn't make the Kahoot, I'm just using somebody else's, so I just searched for it, and I use this one like in the dorm.
Oh, okay.
And so all the students can just play. So something I can use. All right, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, you got that? You don't wanna play, Michelle?
No, I'm gonna make sure I zoom in and zoom out when appropriate.
All right. Now, I'm gonna go. Bear down. Since we already have done MLA before, we're just gonna be playing with it. What does MLA stand for? Someone has a book right in front of them, too. So you're gonna get a book on the time. One more to enter. So for the Kahoot, was it modern literature arts, or is it modern language association? Which one is it?
Modern.
Yeah, that's the language one. Where's the book at? Was it book nine? Yeah, so you, on the front of the book, if y'all haven't seen the book, make certain that it gets in everybody's hands, because Modern Language Association is not only like your nerdiest professors, it's like the nerdiest professors that you can imagine in language arts. So these guys, I think one of them lived in Kansas City, but this group of people, they went and made up rules for this formatting. What's up, Justin?
How's it going?
Log in and just kind of follow along. Or you can tell Josh if he's answering the questions or not. Okay? So, MLA. Let's see who's ahead. Bear down. Good job, good job. Next one. When documenting one author in reference to the text, which is correct?
Oh, Lord.
We use first name, last name, comma, then page. There's also a period in there.
Whoa.
This. Ah. So we had two people answer on there. But let's go see what the answer is on there, the first one. So we're using the last name for the in-text citation, and then the page number. Is there a comma? No comma. And so I'm just going to write this out because it's just a really common question, you know, in my brain. I'm like, oh, how do I write that? And you have the parentheses open, fry, page number 178, close parentheses, period. Because a lot of times you can't remember, do I put the period inside the parentheses or outside? Was there a comma? Now, Justin, I went ahead and jumped into this quizzy game because everybody said, oh, we've done this. Okay? So we're just checking out how everybody's doing. Woo! Bear down! Who is that bear down? Is that you in the blue? Who is that? Is that you, Jeff? Micah? When documenting one author by name in a text, which is correct? Did we just do this one? Fry is one. Fry is one. Why is it the green? Why would they have it to be the green one? Do you see how there's two fries here? You just want one. Fry has argued this point before. Since we already had fry in the sentence, we're just going to do the page. And sometimes I cheat because I can't remember. So I'll say, according to fry in this, and then I know I can just do the page. I cheat. But if you just say the facts, then you're doing the name and the page. Does it make sense? If it's repetitive. Let's see if you did. Bear down, Micah! Come on, you need 8 more points on there. That's okay, Justin. You shouldn't put the author's last name in the citation if the author's name appears in the text. So that was explaining. Order, they mean the last name first. Okay. Woo, Micah. We're at 9, so 2 left. You should underline the title of the text. title page. Can you underline the title of the check? All right, we're going to stop after the last one, so let's see who's winning right now. They're down. One more question. Quotation marks should be placed around titles of shorter works, such as articles or poems. All right, we're going to see who the winner is. And then we're going to close out of this game. Bear down. Jalen. Justin. Justin, man, you missed first couple and you still cruise up there. That's awesome. Morgan, Josh. Now I'm going to close out of this. Ooh. It's a fun game to play, but and I would not have gone into it if you guys said that you had not worked with this before. So that was Kahoot. I'm going to go back in online. What do you use to find out those questions? If your teacher tells you to do MLA, and then you're thinking, I don't remember where the parentheses is. Wow, where do we, how do you Google? What are your keywords on it?
MLA format.
MLA format. Any other words? Do you do video or do you do the actual reading?
I rather do reading.
Uh-huh. Is there anybody else? Because I love video. I have switched to video now, and as I can tell, it's reflective in my writing now. But one of our students, in fact, a video student was just in earlier, and they said they were new to APA format. So we have a formatting direction there, and then from videos, my eyeballs immediately go into looking at this, how much time I'm going to be spending, and then you can see once you're inside there, who made the video. I disagreed with like one of the questions that we had just had, but we're looking at the source of being able to be critical of who made this information. There where is it located? So, this is a USC library in California. Can you go online right now and go into Purdue OWL? We talk about Purdue OWL a lot. One of the good things about like our humanities, and I see like an MLA formatting right here. So this is your friend when nobody else is around. I mean, just like you're just Googling, but Purdue, their writing center was so amazing that the entire country was with them. Notice it looks different this year. They revised it during the summer. It looks very different. And when I looked at it earlier, just to review, I was like, ah, it's different, where's everything? And you're gonna see a different font with it, but you can scroll down right here and you're gonna see the similar drop downs or options. My best tool on there, who's familiar with this one? Do you use it? Yeah. Do you use the sample paper? That sample paper is always my friend on there. It takes a while to load because it's like a lot of pages in there. But the sample paper, it's going to explain a lot of those things that that we do. And if you look in that book that's going around, there's a sample paper in there, and that's probably my most worn spot of the book. And the books are like $12, but I'm sure you can get it used cheaper. So when you have questions about why something is done, or you're questioning how many pages or how many words when you're indenting lines on slide there, Microsoft Word. And if it's not done on your computer, do this. Take Microsoft Word and drag it down to your taskbar. Just drag it down. And you see how it appears down there? And I don't have to now, I don't have to go into programs, I don't have to open up Microsoft Office, and then I don't have to look for Microsoft Word in there. So just click and drag it. And you could fill your taskbar with those things so that it just cuts down the clicks that you're dealing with. I'll do you the traditional way and then the shortcut way. Because one of the things that we're in here, and I see a lot of students do this paragraph in here, once we actually start out and get your name in here, actually, the three people have come today asking the same thing. This is for mass communication class, say 100. I don't think that she has a 100. So. And then our backwards formatting of our date.
And you're probably doing with your eyes closed, huh?
Did you see where that was, where I inserted a heading? You have an insert tab, like right straight up on top, very, very top. And then we're inserting a header, and I chose the first one. And this is like walking through one of those videos that they have. I told you that you can look on YouTube in a 3-minute video on how to format a paper. And when you switch to APA, it's a little bit different. So I'm just pushing this one over to the right. And I'll tell you, I have not done this forever because I use the shortcut. And we're going to do the shortcut to your last name. It should have been insert a page number. I'm having trouble. sorry, and I apologize on that. It should have been insert a page number. That hurt. I hate to make that mistaken for you guys. I don't want you thinking of that one. But you're going to see the shortcut, and you're going to like the shortcut so much better. And that was insert a page number at the top of the page, and I choose the third one. I insert a page number at the top of the page, and I choose the third one. So the page number pops up, and then I just type my last name in the space. And the last one. So then you can see when you go into the next page, it should be there. I see a lot of students that don't center. What they'll do is they'll tab ahead for my wonderful title. You can always insert instead of hit return, 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 return. And Jay Lynn was, she's been taught that shortcut version. You ready for the shortcut? So you can help anybody else, you know, that's halfway through, like, man, I already started my paper, but I don't know how to insert the page numbers. So now you can help them, all right? Because we're gonna miss some students on there. But when you're starting, I want you to do it like Jaylen did. Jaylen, you wanna show us?
Oh, you got it.
I'm cool with it. I like letting other people drive the ship. All right. So you just have new and type MLA. Search for it. You do it now. You do it. And there might be things that you like about this, and there might be things that you don't like about it. At least you know that you can choose now. We have style papers and research papers. Bunch of style papers are just kind of things that humanities ask for. Oh, hey, it's already done for us. Like inserting a number is already done. I'm just going to go up there and type in my last thing now. You will have to remember like your date on there, but your date is backwards. So you have the day first and the month. And right out the month. And right up there to the year. There's things that I don't like about it. And I tend to like cheat by going into the very, I go delete the rest of it. I go into my first paragraph and delete the rest of it. And I'll start right there. But if you save this right now and save it to like your desktop and say my start paper, or just type it start paper and save it to the desktop, then you can email it to yourself. Where do you guys like to save your papers? Are you on drive? So she has a flash drive. Well, she uses flash drives in here. 1, 2, 3, so almost half. Where do you save yours at? Do you do Google Drive?
No. I haven't had one.
Okay. How about you, Michael? Where do you save your data?
On which one? Google Drive.
Google Drive?
Yeah.
So you're pretty good with using those adaptions on Microsoft. Do you have Microsoft at all on your Microsoft? Okay. So if you have it, title it as like my start pager. It's good to have it like, just saves time. You just want to save time on there. I'm going to go into like one source that we're going to do, and I love the source. So let's just go into Google Scholar, because I'm a... So search for Google Scholar. I'm going to show you a fast way on making citations. Because I bet your teacher's going to have a book, and then they're going to have a cite from that book. Why don't you go to Google Scholar? I'm looking at Winona LaDuke's book. Or maybe your teacher gave you a different title. And usually articles in the databases, they have a citation that's with it. But look right here. And now Google Scholar is the one that started last year using these quote marks for the citations. And now some of the databases are using quote marks as a symbol. Citation. So that's a really good cheater right there. So if you click on that citation, and then the when you click on the quote mark, then the citation pops up. Isn't that wonderful? it's wonderful with books. Because you can use a lot of products that you might even pay for, like EasyBib, and they might supply them. Like EasyBib is great for MLA. In fact, I have it on my phone. And I can just scan a book. I can scan the barcode on the book, and it's gonna pull it up. So I have my EasyBib app. And it will flip over to, here's the book, and I'm gonna scan it. And I'm gonna scan the barcode to it. So you've got a ton of apps that are gonna help you. EasyBib doesn't help when you go into APA, but it's wonderful for MLA. Take some time to get to know these, especially on the weekend if you don't have a date. Go to the database and play around. So if I have this one here, and I'm now going to take this, copy and paste it back into my paper. Remember my paper? I'm going to insert my last page, center it. And there's just one more thing I wanted to show you. So this is Works. Is it Work Citing? Or Works Cited. Oh, we just had a quiz on that one. Works Cited, mostly capitalized. I'm going to now hit my double space and Control V, so now I have this. Oh, it wasn't long enough. I wanted two pages or the two liner. Notice that this is a different format or a different font. Picture, use your eyeballs and see this little pad right there. The middle one. Click on it. Because it's going to make a difference when you're in some of the databases. Merge formatting. Oh, look! Now it's New York font too! I'm merging it into there, but you have that as an option that you are taking control of it now. I got to find a long book. Let's see. Title of the long book. From the Native American Voices magazine. It looks like the title is Indigenous Environmental Perspectives in North American Primer, written by the author, Winona LaDuke, who's my hero, written in 2016, page 370. That's how I interpret that information. But now I'm going to take this and, oh, teacher, I've got another one. Look at my second source. That's ugly. What's wrong with that? What's wrong with that? What do I click on the clipboard? Which one should I choose?
The middle.
The middle, thank you. Awesome. Oh, that's a little bit more pretty, huh? Oh man, it's still kind of goofy looking, but what I'm gonna do is highlight this. Notice that it's indented like a paragraph. See how it's indented the first line? Michael, what do I click on to change that? Uh-oh, it's different with Google Drive.
Wait, what?
How would I change this to make it look like an actual citation? We've got to actually have the first line clear over here, like Leduc. I got to move Leduc over here in American. I got to move it over here. It's a hanging indent is what they call it. And there's a couple ways to do it. One of them is grabbing the middle one right here. See that middle one? Oh, it just switched to hanging indent. Did you see that word up there? Man, I'm so old. You see it? Oh, baby. Put that over there. Oh, baby, let me take the top one. And then we'll go back. Oh, yeah. Go on smiling. Or I could just click in the paragraph, go down to indentation, click on hanging, and click on that one. Special with hanging. I remember when I didn't know that, I beat myself up for like 45 minutes because I didn't know it was titled Hanging Indent.